One of the people that purchased one of these CR10 printers had a question about how to change the filament, and that sometimes can be a little bit tricky. You have two fans here. This fan blows across the heat sink that is on top of the hot end. As the filament comes down through here, it passes through the heat sink and eventually gets down through the hot end into the nozzle. And this hot end is what melts the filament. And the extruder, as it pushes on the filament, forces it out through the nozzle. The heat sink is used to help control the temperature of the hot end. And this fan blowing across that heat sink is part of that temperature control. Now, there's an area between the top of the hot end and the bottom of the heat sink that is called the transition zone. And when you retract filament, some of that melted filament is pulled back up to keep from dribbling or oozing melted filament out of the end of the nozzle. If you retract too far, that molten filament can get pulled back up into the heatsink area, and then sometimes you have a little trouble getting going again, and you'll hear this extruder going click, click, click. That's when this brass piece, which is knurled or has all the slots in it, which drives the filament, it can't push the filament, so it's jumping back and forth on this spring. And if you allow that to happen very much, it'll wear away this filament, and then that'll cause some other problems. Now, if this has been sitting here for a while and you want to change the filament, you can try squeezing on this and pulling on the filament, and it will not come out because this thing has been sitting and it's gotten cold. So what you want to do is go to your control box, go to control, come down to temperature, come down to nozzle, and I crank that up to 210 degrees. Click on main, go back to the info screen, and we can watch the temperature come up on the hot end or the nozzle. Once this reaches 210 degrees, I don't get in too big of a hurry. I let it sit there for a while because I want to make sure that that hot end and the filament in the vicinity of it are good and hot. Come up here, click on this, come down to prepare, come all the way down here, move axis. 1 millimeter will allow you to move the extruder. I come down to extruder and I tell it to start extruding, and it will start pushing filament out the nozzle. I don't know if this shows up on camera or not, but it has extruded some orange filament out through the nozzle. Now when this is extruding, that extruder is turning in this direction. It's pushing filament out through the nozzle. When it stops, and I turn it the other way, it is now withdrawing filament back up away from the nozzle, and hopefully it'll bring it all the way up past the heatsink area. And just let that run for a few minutes. I squeeze on this to release the tension on that drive hub, and I see if I can pull that filament. And if I'm lucky, I'm not lucky. It won't bring it quite all the way out. And when I can see it in the tube here, when I get to about this section here, it's probably going to stop. Right there, it stopped. I no longer have my Bowden tube attached to this bunch of wires. These wires are now supported off of a support bracket that comes off the back of this fan cooler. I can reach in here and compress this fitting and release that Bowden tube and pull it off the end of this filament. This filament will have a little knob on the end of it and keeps it from going back inside here. I cut that off. I cut it off at an angle this way, and I cut it off at an angle in the opposite direction so that that's pointed, with the point being in the center of the filament. That will make it a lot easier to reinsert this next time. I'll just go ahead and remove the filament from the extruder. Go ahead and put the next color until it comes out through here. Put the Bowden tube over that and push that into that fitting. That fitting is still compressed, so you want to pull that out. and hold it out while you push that in. Give it a couple of tugs. Make sure that that pinch fitting has gripped onto this Bowden tube. That's a good piece of advice, because I have had this release this tube in the middle of a print, and this can create quite a tangle in about a half hour. And this thing is pushing filament all over the place, and it's no longer going through the hot end or the nozzle. And I push this filament in here until I can watch it come down through this tube. I watch it go all the way down through the hot end, and when it stops, it has reached at least the intermediate zone. I'll go back to the control panel, make sure that my temperature is still 210 degrees. Back to control. So I go back to prepare, move axis, 1 millimeter, extruder, and start extruding the blue filament. I want to do that so that I know that I'm getting good, clean filament coming out the hot end, and that it's not contaminated with any of the orange that remained either in the intermediate zone or in the hot end. Just let that run for a while. Make sure that we're getting good, clean, blue filament coming out of there. When you're squeezing on this handle on top of the extruder to pull this filament out, I caution you against pulling on this filament too vigorously. This filament is fairly brittle, and it will snap off. One other caution, when you're dealing with this filament, a lot of times, you probably can't see this, you'll get real fine threads that will be coming out of here, about like a piece of silk. You want to keep that away from your fan. Those real fine pieces of filament will get sucked into that fan, and it'll get wrapped around the motor. It's not a bad idea to take this apart about once a month and blow the dust and stuff out of here and make sure that stays clean. One other thing that can cause a little grief is if this tube is not pushed down all the way to the top of the nozzle. If this doesn't go down all the way, it'll leave a little gap in there, and that will fill with filament. And then when you're trying to retract it, it'll probably break off there. And that's one reason why I go ahead and I extrude some filament on top of there to make sure that I have flushed out all of the previous color. And some of that is just the nature of the beast. This thing is extruding and retracting and extruding and retracting, and it's working back and forth on these push to connect fittings. You can see how this is chewed up right in here. And this was on the hot end side, and I just reversed the ends on that. I'm not quite ready to replace that tube. There is an option built into the machine. You can go print, pick a file that you want to print, then immediately go back to tune, go all the way down to the bottom and hit change filament. That'll run the extruder backwards for a while, and it'll start beeping at you. You can pull the old filament out, put the new filament in. When you push this again, the head will go to the home position, and it'll start to make the print. It does not give you the opportunity to flush whatever filament may still be in the nozzle.